Hi, this is Sheeta Hunter. In our November Mac Group Detroit meeting, we were discussing the features in Yosemite. One of the features we were discussing was iCloud Drive. Now, we always suggest to our members and to non-members that you always back up your content before you do any type of updating. And we suggested that if you do want to update to iCloud Drive, that you go to iCloud.com and you download any pages, numbers, or Keynote files that you have so that just in case the update does not go well, you will have those files. So I had not planned on updating to iCloud Drive just yet, but I did want to go in and look at a couple of files that I have in the Pages application and iCloud.com. So opening iCloud.com, I went to the Pages application and clicked on it. And this is what I saw. A file or a dialog box talking about iCloud Drive. To use Pages, you need to upgrade your account. Well, I don't want to upgrade my account. I want to get to my files. But as you see, my files are nowhere to be seen. I know that I have at least 25 files on iCloud.com in the Pages app. So I selected Not Now, and still no files. So my question is, how do I get to my files? So I then went to my iPad Air and opened up the Pages application. In the Pages application, I saw at least two of the files. So I thought, if two of the files are here on the iPad Air, maybe more will be on my iPad 3, which is an older iPad. So here on my iPad 3, I see that all of my files are actually there. So how do I get my files downloaded to my computer so that I can then feel secure about updating to iCloud Drive? So after going through a few techniques, this is the technique that I felt was the easiest to get these files out of my iPad and onto my computer. So first, with the Pages application open, I'm going to go up to the upper left corner and click on the share icon. And this technique works because of Dropbox. I have Dropbox on my computer and on my iDevices. So I'm going to select Send a Copy. With Send a Copy, it then asked which file or document do you want to select. I'm going to select, let's go to this one. And then it asks, how do you want to send this? What format do you want to choose? I'm going to choose the Pages format. Now, in the Choose How to Send options here, I'm going to select Send To. And you see the options you have are Message, Mail, and something else if you click More. I'm going to choose the Send To icon, and it brings up a dialog for me to choose what location to send this file to. So I'm going to click on the locations link in the upper left corner, and it has the option of iCloud, Drive, and More. I'm going to choose More, and from here I can select Dropbox, and let me turn Dropbox on, then choose Done, and it takes me back to the choose how to send. And I'm going to click back on Send To, back to Locations. Now, because the first step was to turn Dropbox on, I don't have to turn Dropbox on again. I'm automatically set to save it into Dropbox. In my Dropbox folder, I created a Pages Files folder. The reason this Pages File folder is in the top of the stack is because I put a space in the name at the very front, and that will always place a folder at the very top of the stack. So now the file is ready. I choose Pages Files folder, and then at the very bottom I select Save to Pages Files. This is the folder. Now I've already done this document, so it's going to choose Replace. So it's asking me, do I want to replace or keep both? I'm going to go ahead and select Keep Both, but This is only because I've done this already. You see that it's uploading, and then it takes me back to the Pages icon so I can then repeat this process. So this was the easiest way that I found to get these files onto my computer, and then I can update to iCloud Drive, and if anything happens, and I don't expect anything to happen, but you're always better safe than sorry. So I hope this was helpful. This is Sheeta Hunter. Until next time.